insects as important laboratory tools. Drosophila is a genus of small flies belonging to the family Drosophilidae, whose members are often called fruit flies. One species of Drosophila, in particular Drosophila melanogaster, has been heavily used in research in genetics and is a common model organism in developmental biology. The entire genus, however, contains about 1,500 species and is very diverse in appearance, behavior, and breeding habitat. Scientists who study Drosophila attribute the species diversity to its ability to be competitive in almost every habitat, including deserts. Drosophila melanogaster is a fruit fly of the kind that accumulates around spoiled fruit. It is also one of the most valuable organisms in biological research, particularly in genetics and developmental biology. Basic genetic mechanisms are shared by most organisms. Therefore, it is only necessary to study the genetic mechanisms of a few organisms in order to understand how the mechanisms work in many organisms, including humans. Drosophila melanogaster, a little insect about 3 millimeter long, is an excellent organism to study genetic mechanisms. The general principles of gene transmission, linkage, sex determination, genetic interactions, molecular, biochemical, and developmental genetics, chromosomal aberrations, penetrance and expressivity, and evolutionary change may all be admirably demonstrated by using the fruit fly Drosophila melanogaster and its herders. The related species have been extensively studied for decades and there is extensive literature available. The extensive knowledge of the genetics of Drosophila melanogaster and the long-term experimental experience with this organism, together with extensive genetic homology to mammals, has made it of unique usefulness in mutation research and genetic toxicology. Many Drosophila genes are homologous to human genes and are studied to gain a better understanding of what role these proteins have in human beings. Much research about the genetics of Drosophila over the last 50 years has resulted in a wealth of reference literature and knowledge about hundreds of its genes. It is an ideal organism for several reasons. Number one, fruit flies are hardy with simple food requirements and occupy little space. Number two, the reproductive cycle is complete in about 12 days at room temperature, allowing quick analysis of test crosses. Three, fruit flies produce large numbers of offspring to allow sufficient data to be collected. Examination and data collection is easy because the flies can be quickly and easily immobilized for examination. Four, many types of hereditary variations can be recognized with low power magnification. Five, Drosophila has a small number of chromosomes, 4 pairs, a genome size smaller than the human complement of 23 pairs of chromosomes. The gained polytein chromosomes in the salivary and other glands of the mature larvae show far more structural details than do normal chromosomes, and they are present during interphase when chromosomes are normally invisible. 6. A large number of genetically defined mutants are available, which define most aspects of the fly's biology. 7. Many Drosophila genes are homologous to human genes and are studied to gain a better understanding of what role these proteins have in human beings. Much research about the genetics of Drosophila over the last 50 years has resulted in a wealth of reference literature and knowledge about hundreds of its genes. Yet, the genome is relatively small for an animal, less than a tenth that of humans and mice. 9. Mutations can be targeted to specific genes. This ability to manipulate genes at will represents one of the two most important Drosophila approaches relevant to personalized medicine. The detailed techniques, including the FRT/FLP recombination approach to generate discrete patches of mutant tissue in a wild type background, the GAL4 upstream activation sequence in bracket UAS system for misexpression studies, and the use of inverted repeats to generate RNAi mediated gene knockdown have been well reviewed, and we will introduce the most disease relevant techniques briefly below. Drosophila has a long history of tool building, and with each passing year, the ability to generate transgenic Drosophila genes, manipulate gene expression and direct site specific changes becomes easier, quicker and more powerful. The genetic modifier screen. Perhaps no tool has proven more powerful in Drosophila than the genetic modifier screen. If you are wondering how Drosophila can aid your own work, this remarkably powerful technique should likely be your first consideration. Enhancer and suppressor loci are conceptually similar to the modifier bar susceptibility. Loci commonly searched for in personalized medicine studies. Later, we will provide disease-related examples to illustrate how genetic modifier screens were used to address specific questions in human therapeutics. Targeted expression knockdown. In addition to using genetic tools to test functional links between proteins, advances have made targeted expression or knockdown of genes both easier and more precise. Two major techniques are commonly used to achieve in this stable transgenics, and we briefly outline how they are used. Targeted transgene expression. Many diseases are due to the expression of disease-specific isomers of specific proteins. For example, many solid tumors express the oncogenic RAS isoform RAS G12V, leading to activation of the RAS signal transduction pathway and tumorigenesis. Expression of one or more disease genes is readily accomplished in flies. Researchers typically use either direct fusion of a useful promoter to the genes of inserts, or more commonly by use of GAL4 UAS misexpression system. For example, crossing GAL4 flies to UAS or RAS G12V flies targets oncogenic RAS to the progeny are ready to score in less than 2 weeks. As we discussed below, this approach can provide a useful assay for both genetic screens and for drug discovery and validation. Targeted knockdown. The Drosophila tool set includes the ability to knock out genes in specific tissues. For disease models, a more common approach has been targeted knockdown of a gene using RNAi. This approach reduces genes' activity by destabilizing their transcript. Expression of inverted repeat DsRNA leads to targeting of homologous sequences for degradation by a dicer-mediated complex. This approach works particularly well in flies. Currently, 3 separate collections of flies are available that cover the predicted 20,000 fly transcripts. Each of the 20,000 fly lines contains an inverted repeat transgene that targets a single transcript. This transgene is fused with the UAS promoter to allow precise GAL4 mediated targeting of a gene for knockdown. For example, knocking down the tumor suppressor P53 in the wing simply requires crossing wing GAL4 flies to UAS P53 flies. The F1 knockdown adults will emerge in less than 2 weeks. The ability to knock down any predicted transcript with off-the-shelf reagents simplifies the effort, time and cost required. RNAi, in vivo and cell culture. Many drug and functional screens are more readily accomplished in cell lines. Drosophila cell lines have proven especially useful for this approach, and the Drosophila Genomics Resource Center makes a large number of well-characterized lines available. Although fly cell lines do not take advantage of the ability to screen in a whole animal setting, they are quicker, cheaper and more quantitative than whole fly screens. Moreover, fly cell lines have unique advantages that have attracted numerous researchers of mammalian systems. They are robust, thrive at room temperature. Flies are ectothermic and critically readily take up RNA added to the media. That is, libraries of dsRNA can be screened rapidly through systemic RNAi. Screening in which single or pool of RNAi constructs are added to the media. The Primom laboratory has established an automated facility that permits laboratories to screen a validated dsRNA library, typically against a luciferase readout of the pathway of insects. This approach has been hugely successful in identifying regulators of several pathways, including hedgehog, Wnt, receptor, tyrosine kinase, RAS, metabolism, and other pathways. Disease models. In studies of development, Drosophila provide useful for its powerful genetics, but also it emphasizes on examining mechanism in suit. This whole animal approach is also invaluable for disease studies. Many of the difficulties translational researchers have had can be traced to the differences between diseased tissue with a whole animal cell culture models or conceptually related xenograft models. In this secretion, we consider specific examples of how Drosophila can be used to rapidly and inexpensively generate disease models that are useful for studies of both mechanism and therapeutics. Our purpose is not to be comprehensive, but to point to a small number of illustrative examples of how Drosophila can impact specific issues of disease and personalized medicine. Cancer. Flies provide a natural tool to study the genomics of cancer. As most oncology-related pathways have a long history of study in Drosophila. Indeed, the first tumor suppressor was identified in Drosophila through the pioneering work by Peter Bryant and his colleague. However, only recently, as the fly community embraced cancer as a specific field of focus, the number of fly workers studying cancer is rapidly rising. We bring an in-suit sensibility to questions of tissue development and homeostasis and are comfortable considering impact on the animal as a whole. As such, we anticipate flies will have an increasing impact on our understanding of how mutated genes and gene combinations affect both tumor outcome and even drug response. heart diseases. Heart diseases remains the number one source of mortality in the development world, and yet we still only partly understand the mechanisms that lead to progressive heart deterioration. Drosophila does indeed have a heart. They also have structures similar to other organisms, including the kidneys, lungs, and the liver. The pioneers of Drosophila models of heart disease have been Rofel Bodmer and Karen Ocker, who have taken tools honed in development studies to explore specific issues of disease. They have demonstrated progressive heart deterioration in aging adult flies and have shown that this can be reversed by reducing activity of the insulin signaling pathway. The structural proteins and channels that regulate human heart function are conserved in Drosophila. Several were initially discovered in flies and likely perform similar functions within a fairly simple non-combed tube that moves fly brood hemolymph through the body. Heart function can be measured in detail, and precise M modes can be generated that demonstrate rhythmicity. With these tools plus high sensitivity fluorescence imaging, the fly heart is improving in its ability to be screened for genes and drugs that comprises or improve function. An excellent example of the utility of flies comes from the study of the CEC-UGC potassium channel. In humans, mutations in this potassium channel lead to long QT syndrome type 1, a delay in repolarization of the heart that is associated with arrhythmia and sudden death. Flies mutated for CEC-UGC survive to adult and also, similar to humans, are susceptible to cardiac failure when the heart is artificially paced. Also promising form of personalized medicine standpoint, Drosophila has also conserved the human ether A-GOGO channel, HERG, named after the fly protein due to mutations, uncontrolled movements. HERG has been linked to drug-induced LQT, a potentially fatal side effect common with many drugs tested in the clinics. Mutation of the fly ortholog led to increased rates of arrhythmicity, holding the promise that Drosophila could provide a rapid whole animal assay to detect this serious drug contradiction. Diabetes. Perhaps the fastest growing disease field in Drosophila research is its use as a tool to explore metabolism related diseases. Here we consider work in diabetes, often referred to as an epidemic, that has tripled in incidences in the USA. In just the past 30 years, the utility of Drosophila as a tool for studying diabetes has highlighted by Rulifson, Kim and Newsy, who developed a model of type 1 diabetes to mimic loss of the insulin secreting beta cells in human proteins. They expressed a pro-apoptosis gene in the Drosophila insulin-producing cells, IPCS. Loss of these neuroendocrine cells led to aspects reminiscent of the human disease, including hyperglycemia. Hyperglycemia, aspects of insulin resistance, and altered fat profiles. Further, work has demonstrated the presence of cells that function similar to our alpha cells. These cells secrete a glucogen-like peptide that is predominant in regulating hemolytic glucose levels. Most diabetes patients suffer from the more common type 2 diabetes mellitus, T2DM. New Drosophila models of T2DM are being developed that rely on simple high carbohydrate feeding paradigms. These led to a broad array of effects described in human patients and show both similarities and some differences with type 1 diabetes. A close examination of heart and kidney function in these high sugar fed flies revealed many defects observed in human patients. Genetic screening have indicated a remarkable complexity to the defects imposed by a high sugar diet and have highlighted both the complexity of the disease and the need for a powerful genetic system such as Drosophila to sort out the intricacies. Genomic mapping. Regarding personalized medicine, perhaps the greatest place for future growth in the Drosophila field over the next few years is their potential to provide biological context to the food of genomic data. Drosophila commonly screen hundreds or even thousands of genes in a study assessing functional links and generating new pathways based on functional criteria. In this section, we cite recent examples in which flies have been used with success to address specific issues that emerged in genomic disease studies. Drug discovery. Drosophila has traditionally been a powerhouse as a genetic system. More recently, Drosophila has contributed to the research for compound therapeutics in a small number of other diseases as well. Drosophila holds great promise for drug screening. Combining sophisticated multi-genetic models with the ability to be used in a moderately high throughput drug screen, this approach may identify compounds with better whole animal efficacy and reduced whole animal toxicity. Here, we consider early efforts by the fly community to establish whole animal screening. Coming to the another insect, silkworm, a lab tool. Today's biotechnology based industry faces a bottleneck towards further advancement owing to the lack of proper gene expression systems. In spite of rapid growth of bioscience, there are still many proteins of which structures are unidentified. Scientists concerned in the field of life science desire techniques which can express protein in large quantities and purify protein in form having a biological function quickly. Thus said, with the completion of Human Genome Project, we have come across a Herculean task of trying to understand the function of the proteins being coded by the genes. Silkworms have been in use for human needs for centuries. The silk derived from the silkworm is of great economical value. Lately, insects and in particular silkworms have attracted the attention of expressing proteins of high value which needed post-translational modifications for human application research. At 1985, Dr. Maeda demonstrated that silkworm larvae could produce functional interferon. Since then, to express desired protein of interest in silkworm, various techniques have been developed, and among them baculovirus based expression BES comes foremost. Baculovirus being the ideal vector carrying desired cDNA for interests does not infect nor cause any known disease to humans or other livestock other than its host, thus dismaying any biohazard concerns. Many researchers proved silkworm biotechnology is one of solutions. Up to now, alpha interferon HBEAG sugar modified eukaryotic proteins such as carbohydrate transferases and cell surface receptors have been produced using Bombyx mori silkworm larvae. This work demonstrates great potential advantages of the BMNPV BACMID system for the large-scale expression of foreign genes in the silkworm. Furthermore, recent reports showed that the recombinant baculovirus containing mammalian cell active promoter can exhibit efficient gene transfer of potential vaccines into mammalian cells. This would be a great breakthrough in production of recombinant eukaryotic proteins and viruses, which will be a powerful tool in a new proteome era. The existing progress and discoveries that have been made in Bombyx mori during the past 10 years, which include the construction of a fine genome sequence and a genetic variation map, the evolution of genomes, the advent of functional genomics, the genetic basis of silk production, metamorphic development, immune response, and the advances in genetic manipulation. These advances, which were accelerated by the genome sequencing project, have promoted Bombyx mori as a model organism not only for Lepidopterans but also for general biology. Thank you.